it's a little over the top. And then we'll look at the architecture of today, which doesn't have a name yet. But that's okay, because these others didn't have a name when they started either.
Well, I think every tour you have something a little different that you want to have people take away. The historic's a little different than the modern. I think for me, what I want people to take away from the modern is a different way of looking at the buildings. Because I think most of the modern buildings, we have a feeling that we've seen them before. We think we know them because we've walked past them our whole lives. And, you know, a lot of cities don't have historic buildings, so visitors coming to the city are oftentimes familiar with a modern building, and they kind of look past them. So that's why I want them to really pay attention to a modern building here and to talk a little bit about the different style, how modernism evolved and turned into contemporary architecture. I'm always impressed with the Federal Center, and I think because for a building that seems so deceptively simple, once you know that it's laid out on the grid, and then you can see how everything about the building is on that grid. The flagpole is on the grid, the drains in the floor are on the grid, the elevator doors open on the grid, that it's so perfect, every little detail. I like 1 South Dearborn because I like seeing that. I think it's deceptive. I think it's a building that you can, if you just glance at it, you think, oh, another modern building, it's glass and steel. But if you go around the corner and see, except that corner is coming off at a 45 degree angle. There's a lot of asymmetry going on in that building, and it's the sort of building that's still surprising, that you can't just look at it once and say, oh yeah, I know that building. We saw how some of those modern buildings are in conversation with one another. You know, the postmodern buildings that are referencing buildings that are adjacent to them, and the historic buildings that are nearby. So buildings are conversing with each other, and then we also see how there are the plazas and the public art bring people together. That's what makes a city vibrant. I mean, that's why design matters, is because design either pulls us together or it keeps us apart.
I've told